So today we're going to cover hyperbaric oxygen dosage. It's a common question that comes up. Does it matter if I'm using air only, or if I'm in a clinic getting 100% oxygen, or if I have an oxygen concentrator? Do those numbers really change the dosage, or do those numbers really change the treatment? And so the answer is absolutely yes, it does. And to know that helps a few things. One, if there's a certain protocol, or if a doctor gives a certain prescription that they're expecting to get a certain pressure, a certain percentage of oxygen in order to get a certain dosage for the patient, it's really critical that we're able to match that. Now, sometimes we don't have the same tools, so matching it exactly might be difficult, or you could manipulate different variables in order to get the same level of oxygen absorption or the same level of oxygen dosage. So we're going to cover just a quick example just so you get an idea of how we figure it out and how you could figure it out in order to make sure that you're getting the patient what you think you're getting the patient. So the equation here is that the dosage is the PO2. Okay, so what is the pressure of the oxygen that the patient is getting? The pressure, in order to absorb extra oxygen outside of what we're getting right now, it's all about pressure. That's what hyperbaric oxygen is about. And so the pressure of the oxygen creates a gradient. And as long as you're creating a gradient, you can create a diffusion across the tissue. And that's really what we're looking to do. So the PO2, the pressure of the oxygen, is equal to the percentage, the fraction of the oxygen, the percentage of the oxygen in the mixture that you're breathing, times the pressure of that oxygen is being exposed to. So PO2 equals FO2 times P. In a couple examples, basically 1.5 atmospheres, let's just say we wanted to get a PO2 of 1.5, we could have 1.5 atmospheres times 100% oxygen. That would give us a PO2 of 1.5. So if that was the recommendation or the protocol for the patient, but let's say instead of 100% oxygen, we only had an oxygen concentrator. So let's just say that oxygen concentrator put out about 94% oxygen. Well, 1.5 at 94%, that PO2 equals 1.4. And so that's a different number, obviously. So it's a lower dosage. So therefore, 1.5 at 94% is not the same at 1.5 at 100%. In order to get a similar dosage, what we would need to do is we would need to go to 1.6 at 94% oxygen. That would get us a 1.5 PO2. So again, you could manipulate pressure and oxygen levels in order to get a very similar dosage for the patient. Now, this last one is an example of a PO2 with air only. And so a PO2, let's say you're at 1.5 atmospheres, and the percent of oxygen is 21% in air, you're looking at a PO2 of about 0.31. Massively different. And so, yeah, there's a huge difference between air only versus oxygen concentrator, and some minimal difference between an oxygen concentrator and 100% O2. But to know this, you could start to figure out what the dosages that the patient are getting so that you know that if you're being consistent with the treatment that they're recommending.